In this video, I will show how to use a small EDF for aerodynamic levitation. Please note that this stand has not been well calculated as a thrust tube, it's only a mechanical holder. The EDF I used is a 50mm 11 blades I got from Banggood, while the stand is 3D printed that I poorly designed. I always wanted to play with the aerodynamic levitation, so I needed to have a constant airflow and something that was keeping the airflow straight up. Aerodynamic levitation is very entertainment for a child, because it's fascinating how the object can remain into the air. And they also take the chance to learn how to connect the battery, the speed controller. The airflow is very strong, so you can make also a tennis ball floating there. It is not easy to make other objects floating. I tried with glasses, other peluche, other toys, and they was always hard to keep in equilibrium. You can mainly use balls, ping pong balls for instance. On the bottom, I always place a grid, a protection net, otherwise objects may be sucked into the fan and they may destroy the propeller. How to assemble the EDF on the stand is quite obvious, but I give you some suggestions. I suggest first of all to print the stand exactly for the diameter of your EDF. In my case, it was 60.5mm. Then, you take a piece of foam and you stretch it around your EDF. So the EDF will be centered and not shaky. And consider that the force is pushing the EDF downward. And you close it. And here you have to put M3 screws. Then attach the speed controller to the motor leads. Any contact is okay. If the motor is spinning in the wrong direction, you simply invert two of the ballet connectors. Then you attach the servo tester to the speed controller. And then you can attach the battery to the speed controller. Current consumption for this type of aerodynamic levitation is only 2.3 amps, so you can play for 2 hours with a battery like this.